today we're gonna be doing another People's Court reaction. But of course, before we get started, I have to give a really big disclaimer. People wanna be mowing the lawn for the past like hour. I apologize, I genuinely don't understand. So hopefully I could talk over it. Hopefully the reaction's loud enough. Hopefully my editor can make it sound a lot less worse than what the fuck it sound like. Hopefully you guys don't hear anything. So with that being said, let's get straight into the reaction. Make sure you guys smash that like button, smash that subscribe button, smash everybody you know that can help a sister out. And peek the description box for everything that you guys always ask me for down below. So let's get straight to it. So we're gonna be reacting to two idiots.
She says she and the defendant were dating the same guy. The woman had anger issues, went berserk one night, and threw a brick through her car window. She thinks the woman did all this in a fit of jealous rage because her man was cheating on her. She says she was dating the guy for 4 years and then found out he was cheating on her with a flimsy plaintiff. To make matters worse, she was having a baby with him. The damage to the plaintiff's car was not done by her, even though she had every right to be mad at her. It was done by a wild bunch of kids, even a fireworks show. Bottom line, she's a hard-working mother and doesn't go around vandalizing cars.
Are we fighting over a Dusty that's in jail? Throw the whole case away. This leap off at sense. It don't make any damn sense. And then I see kids involved in this shit. It really don't make any damn sense.
$4,865.68, the amount you say it's going to take to fix your car that you say she damaged.
She came to my house with her kid, vandalized my car.
Huh.
What happened was...
How did you two know each other?
It's over an ex of hers.
Yeah, you can you tell me the story?
He was living with you.
She wanted to.
I kicked him out. He was living with you. Yes. You kicked him out. I found out he was messing with her. That's why you kicked him out. We was together for a year. I'm pregnant by him. We see each other.
You're the guy you're dating gets you pregnant and cheats on you knowing you're pregnant and you took him back?
I didn't take him back. He was going to my doctor's appointments with me and stuff like that. We went out to eat together.
Didn't you just say messing around? Okay, that's taking him back.
Don't be like this. I could never understand people that do shit like this. First of all, it is entirely shitty to cheat, but it's even more shitty times infinity to cheat on someone when they're pregnant. And then, honestly, I just need to tell you this right now. If you're a woman and you let some man treat you like this, he's always going to treat you like this. And he's never going to have any respect for you. This is just ridiculous. Like, why would you let somebody do this shit to you and then take them back? Like, what the fuck? I don't give a fuck if that's your baby father. What the hell type of example are you setting for your other children when you let a man cheat on you and then you take him back when he cheats on you when you're pregnant at that?
Give yourself a little worth, you know?
Right.
So go on.
So anyhow, 3 weeks later, it was the 4th of July. She comes to my house, vandalizes my car with her children. Well, my kids was in the car. Three of my kids.
How did it happen? Explain how it happened.
Y'all want to fight you? I want my one. That's what her daughter was saying.
Wait, stop. You are where when this happened?
In my car.
Who else is inside the car?
My 4 kids and my, Devin's sister, her son.
Sister. By the way, where's Devin right now?
In jail.
Y'all fighting over a Dusty in jail. And I'm mad they said it like, in jail. There's actually nothing funny about that. What? Y'all both got kids fighting over a Dusty in jail? And I guarantee you, one of them is absolutely positively putting money on his books. Getting him commissary, all types of bullshit.
So, you get out of the car.
Mm-hmm.
But you need to
hold on, did y'all peep that? That was letters. That was jail letters. He be writing her letters from jail and she trying to flash it to the other girl. Like, look, he writes me letters. That's what that was. Like, girl, like, why are you flexing a man in jail? He can't do nothing for you. He can't pay your bills. He can't literally be there for your child when the child comes into the world. And you sitting here flexing a man that's locked up that literally is the cause of your car being wrecked because of his ex fucking your shit up. Make it make sense. It's like, why is that a flex?
So you leave the children inside the car. Where do you go?
So upstairs to charge my phone. The rest of the story I can't tell you because they would have to tell you because I didn't see nothing.
Who is it? Who's
I didn't even know they vandalized my car.
Shanice is the one who did it with her.
She was with her and did it with her.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Stand up. How old are you?
This ghetto. And they got the kids in the ghetto. Why they got these kids involved in this? See, this is the type of shit where diapers need to start getting involved because these kids about to be headed in the wrong way fast. Headed towards the... This sad. This is really, really sad. This girl about to implicate herself. I don't believe it.
We were coming from the fireworks, me and her two daughters and a group of boys. There's a lot of us. And we all got dropped off on the street she lives on. And like, everybody was just screaming, "Where's Siobhan? Where's
Siobhan?" Why? Why were you doing that?
I don't know. It wasn't.
No, who instigated it? Who started to talk to you and say, "Hey, let's go do this"?
Her oldest daughter, Diamond, because her mom has problems with Siobhan.
And so you decided to just go do it?
The judge is so into this story, as am I, bro. I'm like, the fuck? Bro, I can't believe this shit. They literally got one of the children who vandalized the car to pull up. But I'm curious as to why she's not also suing the guardian of this child because they helped her. But I mean, maybe she, I don't know. Let's see how that goes. If you guys did not catch it, she's actually 13. She a big ass 13. What y'all feeding these kids? It's the hormones and the food. This is so childish. Over a man that's in jail. I don't think anyone is grasping the severity of this. Like, this is a man that can't offer you anything but a fucking letter on some cheap ass paper from the penitentiary. Like, ooh, y'all need to get it together, bro. Y'all really need to get together. And then you having a baby by this man for what?
Diamond is yelling, "Where's Siobhan?" to Cheyenne, just yelling, "Where's Siobhan? I want to fight her. I want to fight her." Cheyenne responds back, "My mom's at work." And a couple minutes later, Siobhan pulls out her car, and that's when she got out. But we didn't realize the kids were still in there. And when we did realize it, Amy had yelled out, "I don't give up about the kids," and continued to throw up.
Yes. The first person to throw a brick was whom?
Diamond.
Did you see Amy throw something at the car too?
Yeah.
Dating Devin for about 4 years. Put him out. He was dating her for a couple of months. He needs bond money. She gave it to him.
I gotta pause. That little girl done snitched like a canary. And she was with them doing the whole damn thing. So I wanna see how she gonna weasel her way out of this.
Oh, incident about me destroying her car. Never even got out of my car. The little girl, Sharnice, she was also there at the scene. They was dancing on the top of her roof of her car, throwing bricks. Did I not tell y'all, do not destroy that lady's car? Y'all need to get out of the car.
In the Bay Bay, Kansas, go or dance on top of the car. She implicated herself in the scene of a crime during an act of a crime, honestly. What reason would she have to lie? I don't understand. So I was like, did not tell y'all not to do that to that lady car? No, you didn't. You don't even like the bitch. She's having a baby by your ex. Potential somebody you still messing with in the penitentiary. Like, I'm very sure you didn't tell those kids not to do nothing to that car. Why'd y'all even pull up in the first place? Why y'all even there? That's the first question. Like, oh.
Never even got out of my car. My daughter called me to come and pick me up to tell me that there was an incident. Said something to my daughter, was in my daughter's face. So my daughter was there. There's more than about 30, 40 children outside. They are destroying this lady's car, but I never witnessed my daughter throw a rock. Did I see Sharnice kick the lady's car? She keyed the car.
Can you stop a second?
Yeah.
I understand you're the only one with a motive, right?
Why would that child try to implicate you unless it's true? What has that 13-year-old child got against you?
I say she solicited those other 30 however kids to fuck up that girl's car. I personally think that clearly, like the judge said, she don't know what a motive, and that's the only way that could happen, because why are random kids just fucking up somebody's car? I mean, there are some badass kids, and I have seen some. Yeah, let me not say that, because when I was living in my previous apartment, I made a whole story talking about it, and literally, I remember one time, it was a bunch of kids out front of the house, and they literally were just jumping on top of somebody's car, like, nonstop, and I was just so shocked. Like, I never seen nothing like it, so I mean, yeah, it is possible. It is possible.
Why would she implicate herself?
I'm not even sure why she's implicating that I threw a rock through the car. I never even got out of my car, Judge. The police never come to talk to me about this incident.
The lady I haven't spoken to right in the corner, is she a moral supporter or a witness?
Yeah, she heard the voicemails and stuff. She was calling my phone a lot, harassing
me. Voicemails?
Beforehand? Do you have do you have voicemails?
Voicemails
for me to hear? Do you have voicemails?
Yes.
Plan!
You told me you didn't know vandals, I didn't put my hands on your car, but you're still me, right? You're still me? Yeah. Put your hands on me.
Look
here. But you
understand. Yeah, hey. What are you two staring each other down?
I'm gonna let you be that. You're scared of me.
All right, did this bitch like remember verbatim the voicemail? That's a little weird.
You know damn sure I ain't touch your car. You know damn well I ain't touch your car. And all my witnesses gonna come to this one day. I can't wait. You stupid raggedy.
It just says that she's pretty malicious and she's a bitch and she's saying she ain't do nothing. She's just saying it wasn't me. Where's all the witnesses she said she was going to have? I don't see not one witness on her side. She said just wait. I don't see not one witness, so I don't understand. Like, girl, sit down. It definitely is a character type of assassination. Like, god damn.
I tell you, when you play those messages, there's several things. She is absolutely, positively furious for being accused of throwing the bricks. It's not an admission. It's the opposite of an admission, whatever. Is that you're kind of enjoying this.
Right.
You kind of both are. You're not mortified about everything that happened, that a group of children were corralled into doing something evil, but you're like, you know, chicken necking while you're playing the thing and staring her down. And I don't get either one of you. I am sorry that you have children who have to witness this.
I'm giving you three choices. If you were dating somebody and they were secretly seeing somebody else, would you be mad at the person you're dating, the other person, or both?
I think both, because after a while, you know, you feel like he's leading a double life.
And at the person I'm dating, because they know that we're in a relationship.
I'd be mad at myself for actually getting into that relationship in the first place, because I should have known better than that.
I would be more so mad at the person I'm with because they're the one that owes me the loyalty, and mad at myself because either I didn't see the signs or ignored the signs. Mad at the other person only if I know for a fact that they knew about me. Comment down below. What would y'all do? Because
it's one thing when grown women decide that they want to debase themselves and over a guy who clearly was going back and forth and back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
You lifted the letters he sent you from prison. You lifted them because you wanted her to see that he was writing you. That is one of the sickest things I've watched. Everything that's happened, the danger that your one-upsmanship put your children in. You're still playing the one-upmanship game.
It's disgusting.
Both disgraceful, disgraceful role models for your children. Because it's bad enough if you hurt each other, but when you start enlisting children to live the disgusting lives, when you pick that path for the children,
turn up.
I'm horrified.
I'm so happy she said something to them, because I was just like, what the fuck is going on? Lifting the jail letters, sitting here playing that voicemail, all of that, like the chicken necking, and like, it was too much. It just sounds like all of this is petty. Like, it all is petty. Like, my main concern is, what if one of these kids that was there was injured by these rocks and the brick that was thrown at the car? I don't think anyone's even thinking about that. They're just thinking about one-upping each other. And that's very, very disappointing, because there's kids, their own kids in this. You know, her older daughter, the defendant's older daughter, was the one apparently instigating this whole thing. How about she would have got a brick thrown at her ass? Like, that's just sad. It just really is.
Give me the pictures of the car and give me the estimates for the repair.
They really brought the brick.
I find in favor of the plaintiff in this case in the amount of the $4,865.68. That is my judgment.
What? Wait, the car can't move no more? How the fuck? That's a lot of money.
I have nothing to say. I would never, ever coach my child or want to throw bricks. The vandalism was already going on. My daughter called me to come and get her. Yes, I'm a great role model for my daughters.
No, you're not.
I'm just glad justice is served for my kids and my car could get finished worked on.
Alrighty. Well, that was a lot. That was probably one of the most ghetto cases I think I've ever seen on the People's Court. Bottom line, imagine sitting here flexing that you have a jailbird and you're pregnant by a jailbird who's sending you letters. The joke's on you. You're spending hundreds of dollars putting money on this man's book for commissary and probably, possibly, for him to call another bitch, because we all know he's probably cheating on her right now with the same defendant or with another girl while he's in jail. He's gonna get out of jail and he's probably gonna cheat on you. He's gonna get out of jail. He's probably gonna be a deadbeat. He's gonna get out of jail and probably take a whole nother woman yet again. Let's be real, because that's how a lot of people who are in jail are. They only keep you for a lifeline and then they see what's outside and they forget all about everything you've done for them while you were on the inside. So it's just very interesting to me how, like, they're really sitting here fighting over this man. Like, this man must be like freaking Pablo Escobar or some shit. Like, I don't get it. Like, he must be the grand poobah of something. Like, and I guarantee you he probably not. But it's just weird how a lot of people really demoralize themselves in order to keep a man, or in order to save face, or in order to just have a man in general. And it's like, a lot of these men are not even worth a piece of paper, okay? They're not even worth the poop that comes out of your ass, okay? And that sounds harsh, but it's true. Like, a lot of these men, these women, these people that a lot of you guys are fighting to keep wouldn't even do the same for you and just are not worth it. This is ridiculous. I just feel bad for those kids, because I'm very sure that not only were the kids coached, but but they definitely had to probably have witnessed a lot of ghetto shit. I really hope that they're both of them are okay though, because this looks like some shit that could escalate into something really serious in the future. And with that being said, comment down below. I would love to hear your thoughts and opinions down below. Have you went through something similar like this? Do you know anyone that is like in love with a jailbird and would do anything to keep them? Because I really think people like that are very fucking strange. It just doesn't make any damn sense. And of course, make sure you guys peep the description box for everything that I always talk about down below. Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that, and I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye.